Spare ass Annie. When I became captain of the town, I decided to extend asylum to certain citizens who were persona non grata elsewhere in the area because of their disgusting and disquieting performances. One was known as Spare Ass Annie. She had an auxiliary asshole in the middle of her forehead like a baneful bronze eye. Another was a scorpion from the neck down. He had retained the human attribute of voice and was given to revolting paroxysms of self-pity and self-disgust, during which he had threatened to kill himself by a sting in the back of his neck. He never threatened anyone else, though his sting would have caused instant death. Spare ass Annie. Another, and by far the most detrimental, was like a giant centipede, but terminated in human legs and lower abdomen. Sometimes he walked half erect, his centipede body swaying ahead of him. At other times he crawled, dragging his human portion as an awkward burden. He was known as Centipeter because he was continually making sexual advances to anyone he could corner. And anyone who passed out was subject to wake up with centipede in his bed. One degenerate hermaphrodite known as Fish Cunt Sam claimed he was the best lay in town. Besides, he's a perfect gentleman in every sense of the word. He's kind and good, which means nothing to the likes of you. Spare ass Annie. These creatures had developed in the region where the priests carried out strange rites. They built boxes from moist, fresh bones of healthy ewes, captives from neighboring tribes. Pregnant women were placed in the boxes and left on the peak for a period of 3 hours. Often the women died, but those who survived usually produced monsters. The priests considered these monstrosities a way of humiliating the human race before the gods in the hope of diverting their anger. These horrible freaks were highly prized and they lived in the temple. The women who gave birth to the most monsters received gold stars, which they were authorized to wear on ceremonial occasions. Once a month, they held a great festival in which everyone gathered in a round stone temple, open at the top, and prostrated themselves on the floor, assuming the most disgusting and degraded positions possible, so that the gods would see they were not attempting to elevate themselves above their station. The habit of living in filth and humiliation finally occasioned a plague, a form of acute leprosy that depopulated the area. The surviving freaks, who seemed immune to the plague, I decided to receive as an object lesson in how far human kicks can go.